Across the country, thousands of farming families work tirelessly around the clock.
Stop arguing, girls. Give over.
But there's one day each year when they get to leave the daily routine behind.
Right, here we come, Dorset.
Fingers crossed.
There are nearly 10,000 dairy farms in the UK, home to almost 2 million cows. They supply us with millions of litres of milk every day and are the backbone of British agriculture.
Come on.
Today we're meeting two families from Kent. Trevor Warren and Holly Bereen and Ben Dyer are getting ready to show their prize animals at this year's county show in Surrey. It's their chance to show their hard work to the world and to compete for top prizes.
Come on, girl.
On a farm just outside Dover in Kent, it's the start of a new day. It's 5 a.m. and Trevor and his son are already hard at work on the morning milking.
I love milk. I drink milk every day. I drink at least 3 pints, 4 pints a day. It gives me that... gives me a buzz when I drink it.
Well, I tell everybody, drink milk keeps you young.
For 42-year-old Trevor, dairy farming is a passion, handed down through generations.
My father's side were all herdsmen. My dad, he's milked cows. My granddad milked cows, and my great-granddad, he milked cows. It's a job, but it's also a hobby for me. The skill of getting high yields out of cows, that drives me. I mean, when the milk tanker comes and you get the milk ticket to see how much milk's in the tank, that gets me going big time, big time.
For Trevor, farming his 660 cows on his 800-acre farm is hard work with very long hours. He starts at 4 a.m. and he has a busy day full of milking and constantly tending to his herd. Luckily, he has a large family to help. His wife, May, is in charge of the calves.
When they see the bags, that means food time.
His eldest son, 22-year-old Sonny, works on the farm and manages his own herd of Jersey cows. While his other son, Ollie, works the tractor, helping with the harvest. Next comes 6-year-old daughter, Cleo, and 5-year-old son, Jude. And 4-year-old grandson, Tyler, who are all learning the ropes. Even new baby Hope is being started early.
Hope loves the cows. She loves coming out on the farm.
I'm passionate about encouraging youngsters into this industry.
Right, you're going to lead it?
There's a lot of youngsters who think it's just about work, 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 work. Well, it is hard work.
Hold this hand on.
But there's also a lot of passion, pride. My young son Jude, when he started to lead his calf, he was so proud of himself. You know, he wants to be like what I'm trying to do. And that's why I do it. My daughter Cleo, she's like, Dad, I want to train my calf. But sometimes I have to calm her down, she's so keen.
There you go. I think the mouse, the mice have been chewing it.
While Trevor has his family to help him, just down the valley, his friends Ben and Holly and doing their milking on their own.
Hey, come on, girls.
Neither 30-year-old Ben nor 25-year-old Holly are from a farming background, but both were smitten from an early age.
We used to go for days out at the Kent County Show with my family and just loved watching the dairy cows, the whole stalls walking around the ring, and it was just something I really wanted to do. Loved it, addicted to it.
I just really, really love animals and found dairy farming, and I wanted to have a go at milking cows, and it just went from there. I didn't look back.
It's this love for dairy farming that first brought them together when Ben needed help with some show cows.
I offered to help with clipping his cows. So, yeah, I clipped his first team. And
she'd done a good job, so she stayed. Pretty much.
Basically.
This very committed couple are employed by the farm owner to manage the 340-strong herd virtually on their own. So while Ben does the milking, Holly has to give the hungry calves their breakfast.
Let's put these out.
So every calf gets 2 litres. I broke my 2-litre jug, so I'm on a 1-litre jug. So actually scooping. Okie dokie, let's go. I always talk to the cows, especially the calves as well, like, especially when you're teaching them to get onto the teats and stuff. Yeah, there's a lot of talking involved and like you're coaxing them to do it, and so I'm just talking them through how to do it. That sounds so weird.
Not that they got a clue what we're going on about, but...
Ben and Holly's dream is to own a farm of their own. So they've been buying calves gradually to build up a herd.
This is one of mine and Ben's calves. We have 3 heifer calves. We are going to rear on so that we have our own nucleus herd here, and 2 bulls. We're looking to sell those towards the end of the year and hopefully make a little bit of money. I love the face of this one. It's really, really different. Yeah, unfortunately he's a male, so he's gonna go to market, but yeah, he's got a really standing out face with these 2 white patches. He was born, I was like, wow, it was awesome.
The calves and the morning milking might be done, but there's still hundreds of cows over 200 acres to be checked and fed.
So these cows are just having a bit of a break at the moment. This is sort of like holiday time for them. So yeah, we come out here once a day, check them round and everything, make sure there's nothing going on, make sure they're all right.
Ben and Holly have been living and working together on this farm for 5 years now.
Smooth.
Dairy farming is their life, as well as their passion.
You've got to love cows to do this job. I think.
Yeah, it's a huge commitment.
Yeah. Definitely, they're definitely part of your life. I see these cows more, I see some of my friends and family, really.
Not only do they have to work such long hours, dairy farmers also have to cope with an unpredictable milk market. So farmers are always looking for ways to improve the amount of milk the herd produces, using careful breeding and the latest technology. On Trevor's farm, he's finished the milking. It's 10 a.m. and time to check if any of his cows are ready to become mothers.
Come on, girls. Go on, Hope. Get in there. Go, girl. What we're doing now is just checking if these cows are in heat.
After an examination, Trevor's happy that his cow, Hope, is ready to begin the breeding program. Like many dairy farmers, Trevor buys in bull samples. Breeding technology has become so advanced that he can even choose what characteristics Hope's calf will have.
Overall, she's a great type, but I'd like to increase her milk production, and it won't increase hers, obviously. I talk like it's going to increase her milk production, but the next generation will be a lot better milker.
Breeding good stock is so important for Trevor and his family's future that he's willing to pay hundreds of pounds for samples.
That's what it comes in. Let's give it a little shake. And then we're going to defrost it. 40 seconds. That's it. It's gone.
Even for an expert farmer, there's no certainty his cow will fall pregnant. For now, all Trevor can do is keep his fingers crossed. Meanwhile, Ben has noticed that a cow due to give birth is lying down and not moving. The calf could be stuck.
It's been calving for a few hours now. I'm not really getting on with anything, so I'm going to put my hand in there, have a check, make sure it's all in the right position. And like sometimes I can be backwards or have a leg stuck or something, so I just want to check, make sure it's all in the right place.
But this potential new mother doesn't want to play ball. For these young farmers, a successful birth is vital to the business. They'll do anything they can to save the calf.
Let's get her in, Pat. Let's get her in.
Eventually, they get her into the barn. Ben gets a proper look at her and finds the calf is out of position.
She had one leg back behind the other one, so I've just corrected that, pulled it up forwards. Go out there.
It's important for Ben to get the calf out as soon as possible.
Just want to get it out now. Take that gate back a bit now.
For Holly, these are the most challenging moments as a farmer. And in just a few minutes, Ben helps the cow give birth to a healthy calf.
A nice little heifer.
After thinking they were going to lose her, it's a proud moment for everyone.
If Ben hadn't gone in, we could have lost mum and calf. She's had a lovely, healthy calving, as you can see. She's licking it like crazy, and I do feel like I'm their mum, because obviously the mums, you know, they've got to go to work, and I'm their nanny.
Before long, this newborn is already strong enough to take her first steps in the world. For both these farms, the cycle of pregnancy and birth is at the very heart of what they do. After all, it's new mothers that make milk. But for these competitive farmers, there's something else in their minds. Show day.
Showing is a very, very important part of what I do. You're getting an opportunity to exhibit your animals. If we win the first prize in the ring, then we are able then to market the genetics from that one cow, and we can profit from it. It's another form of income instead of just the milk. And that's what we've got to do. You've got to make the money from the genetics as well, because we've invested a lot in it.
With the show looming, there's a lot to get done, especially if just two of you run the whole farm.
When showtime comes, there is a huge amount of extra work to do on top of your normal routine. Farm life comes first.
Is just our little thing.
Extra. We do that on top of the farm stuff. There's a lot of competition in the industry at the shows.
You don't want to lose. You go because you think you've got a good cow.
We take it so personally because, you know, you work with them every single day and you want to win. I have to clip 13 animals within a few days of the show, so that's highly intense. Especially as I could easily spend 2 hours on one cow to get her ready. So to
there is a lot of this involved. Come on, Holly.
Over at Trevor's, he's also thinking about the show, and it has a special and romantic significance for Trevor and me.
When I started showing dairy is when I met Trevor. It was actually at the Eden Bridge show that we met.
Yeah, we wasn't dating. We just met then, sort of got to know each other, and then a few months later, May wanted a calf to show, so she came up and picked a calf, and then, yeah, the rest is history. Got talking about cows, and I realised May would listen to me, because nobody listens to me, really. They like, can you shut up about cows, please? No, there's more to life than cows. Well, no, there isn't, and May agrees with that.
And the dairy theme even carried through to their wedding day.
It took a bit of persuading May for me to have a milk churn to sit on, but... Well, it did a little bit, so, yeah.
Romance aside, Trevor's ambition for this year's show is to come home with a different kind of trophy. This time, for his champion cow.
So this is Lucy. She's a show cow, and she's a seriously good herd cow as well. I just love looking at them. I just love it. Just what I get a buzz out of it, like anybody who'd look at their lovely sports car or something like that. That's why it's so nice to go to a show and compete, and then when you get there, you just feel, whoa, yeah, you know, it really gives you that real buzz.
So, two farms who believe their cows are the best. And to make it more interesting, Ben and Holly will be going head-to-head against Trevor at this year's show.
Well, Trevor's a very good friend of mine, and he got me into cows. He's got such a passion for it, and it rubbed off on me. Now I just want to beat him.
Ben worked for me when he was younger, and he's gone on to do the rest himself, really. But he's got this great cow, and she's been trying to take on Lucy at most of the shows, and at the Ken she pipped her to the post. I was happy for Ben, but I was absolutely gutted and had a little lump in my throat that Lucy had come second, because I was really excited that she might get first.
Where we're one all so far, and so yeah, it's best out of three.
It's a rivalry that's played out for years, but tomorrow's show will be the decider.
It'll be the final.
Yeah, the final one for this year.
Could literally go either way.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes.
After all their hard work and months of preparation, the day of the show has finally arrived. The prestigious Edenbridge and Oxted show in Surrey is starting to come to life. It's one of the highlights of the local farming calendar and an important show for the cattle breeding community. Up to 40,000 visitors are expected through the gate to experience the best of what the rural southeast has to offer. In the dairy section, preparations are in full swing. The cow's beauty parlour is open for business.
It's like going to the hairdressers. It's like the cow salon, and then we do our hair later on with it. So.
Over at Ben and Holly's stall, true beauty takes time.
We started at 2:30 this morning. Washing, getting these ready, cleaning up all the poo.
I love show mornings. It's just a mad rush to get everything done. There's a bit of dirt there.
When Holly squeegees them off, she didn't clean the squeegee first.
Who was doing the squeegeeing? You.
For the farmers, cow beauty works on an industrial scale, with clipping, blow drying, powder, and even super strength hairspray.
Hi, Ben.
All this hard work is to hide any imperfections and give them the best chance of winning.
We're trying to reduce the flaws, so we're trying to trick the judge. Cheating.
No, the cheating is the 50 quid we gave him this morning.
We're not cheating, we're just trying to make her look beautiful.
But jokes aside, the boys are keeping a close eye on each other, with so much at stake.
We're going to battle it out today.
bit nervous, really. You always are. It's all about competition, isn't it?
It's not long to go before everything kicks off, but Ben and Holly have spotted a problem with one of their cows.
She's been too comfortable and eaten too much and made more milk than we assumed she would have done.
The fullness of the cow's udders is a big factor in judging. One of their girls is already at the perfect milk level.
She's looking spot on now for the class, where we would want it to be in 2 hours' time. So we're thinking, you know, 2 hours more milk, is it then going to spoil her by having too much milk on her?
They need to decide whether to milk her or wait. The welfare of the animals comes first.
Can she wait? When's the class? What's the time now?
7:15.
7:15.
Ben decides she's fine and wants to get her ready for the show ring.
We'll do it, and we can always just take a little bit off, can't we? That's Holly's not impressed face.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, Trevor has a few problems of his own. There's something wrong with his cow's food.
Ben, you haven't got any spare food, have you, which I can have, because mine's gone hot.
Are you want some food, do you, mate?
Yes, please. Yeah,
we'll help you out, no worries.
Have you got some spare?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Need some food.
That's really good of you, mate.
No worries, mate.
Thanks very
much. We'll help you out.
The show is starting to fill up, with crowds eager to see what's on offer.
This is a 10-minute warning. We are going to be starting at 9 a.m. Thank you.
Time is ticking towards the first competition of the day. Ben and Holly simply can't manage all the prep on their own, so they've enlisted a team of helpers.
They're brilliant. We have done a show without them, just the two of us, and we took a big team, and it was mayhem.
And Holly's mum is filling in as chief cow beautician.
What we're putting on is a coat product that will make them shiny and look sleek. You can't see it so much on the white cows, but it's much more evident on the black ones.
But it's not just the cows that are getting ready.
Nervous. We're getting really nervous now. It's like these last 5 minutes take forever.
Mum, do you reckon you could run to the tent, please, and get my tie, please? Can you run now? Because you'll probably have enough time.
The competition is moments away, but Holly's not happy.
You know, on that show shine stuff, someone's accidentally done the jet setting and now it looks a bit silly. Yeah? I think that's probably Mum.
Today's dairy cow competition will be judged by farmer Ben Yates, who's also brought along the family for the day out.
I've been judging about 8 years now. Been showing cows about 15 to 20 years. We're looking for cows that we can see can survive in our systems at home, which have got plenty of strength. They've then got to have great feet and legs so they can walk round farms into milking parlours. And then we want a really good udder that shows they can produce milk. Engaging the audience when we're judging is very important. I want to be able to tell people what I'm looking for and explaining what the difference, why this one's better than that one. I try to make sure everybody knows exactly what I feel there is the difference, and hopefully the exhibitors understand what I'm saying too and feel that I've given them the right reasons too.
But what makes a good cow can be a matter of very broad opinion.
Everybody's got their sort of cow they like, whereas you have a judge who has a different opinion and you could really burn.
Yeah.
Holly and Ben enter the ring for their first round.
Blocking me. 188.
First of all, I'd like to thank Eden Bridge and Oxford Show for inviting me to judge the show today. Real privilege to come down here, and great to start the day off with such a good class.
They're each leading a calf they believe can win.
Once classes begin, it's one after the other after the other. And it's a brilliant adrenaline rush.
You don't really have time to think about the last class.
Yeah, you don't.
You're in on the next one.
Ben and Holly have worked hard to breed these calves to show level. A win would mean everything. Time to make a decision. And Ben's calf takes first prize. An incredible start. And it's not just the crowd who are impressed.
Without further ado, we're going to lead off with this calf. This calf, I fell in love when it first came in the ring. A real sharp calf, a calf with a real big future, a real cow-making heifer, I hope.
It's a great first result for them both.
Good start, yeah. See how the rest of them do.
Good. That was good. Great start to the day.
The show is in full swing, and the public are flooding in. Over in the cattle section, they're ready for the next competition. After a morning of sprucing up the cows, time for Trevor to turn the spotlight on himself.
Well, you've got to look smart against a smart cow. Try to, anyway. I'm not very good at doing ties, though. But there you go. That's not bad for me, to be honest. It says Holstein Young Breeder there. I like that. That means I'm still a young breeder if I wear this tie.
With an early win under their belt,
yeah, that's fine, that fits well.
Holly and Ben are feeling hopeful.
There we go.
But things could change now that he and Trevor are going head to head.
Yeah, we're getting close now. Nerves are there. I've already run to the toilet once, so that bit's out of the way.
Both are bringing out their big guns. It will be Ben's prized Alison up against Trevor's champion, Lucy.
She's doing all right, Lucy. Let's just see how she goes. Would have liked a little bit more milk on her. And I would have liked her to just relax a little bit. All my cows seem to be really fired up today. I don't know if it's Ben sabotaged me with the food he gave me. It might have something in it and made him a bit hypo.
As they wait to be called in, Trevor can't help doing a little last-minute comparison with Ben's cow. Trevor and Ben enter the ring. There's no competition like the competition between two dairy men.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we come to our first in milk class, and what a credit this class is. We may not be in a big dairy country down here, but what quality have we got in this class is quite tremendous.
There are four others in the ring, but they're only interested in each other.
Morning, mate.
It's a friendly rivalry, but Ben wants to show his former boss he's his own man.
He's wrong, please.
And Trevor wants to prove he's still got it.
Steady, steady, steady.
It's getting tense as the judge scrutinizes each cow. Now, he must decide.
Steady, steady, steady. Steady.
And Trevor takes first prize.
The judge pulled me up at the front, number one. That was it. I was just ecstatic.
She's the sort of cat that's either at the top or at the bottom, and unfortunately today she's at the bottom. But that's the way showing goes.
You know, Ben, I didn't like looking at his sad face, but then I had a really smiley face, so, you know, it made me buzz.
Ben's cow was just like, just when you get in amongst them, she wasn't just quite clean enough for me.
I mean, I'm happy. Trevor's cow is a good cow. Don't like living to it.
It's midway through the day, and time for a spot of lunch. For everyone. After the stresses of the morning's competitions, Trevor gets to celebrate his lead by taking some time out with his family. Edenbridge has been running since 1837, making this the 179th show. For generations of farmers, it has been a well-earned day out. But for the many urban visitors that come every year, this home county show is an important link with the countryside and rural life.
It's a really lovely show. We've got our cows and our sheep all set round us in a close place. So a real good place for the public to come and see what's going on at the show and all the different animals that are on farms. Shows like this are very important. We've got to educate everybody to what our industry is about, where milk comes from, that it is a 24/7 job. It is important. You know, milk is one of the key ingredients to life, really.
Especially popular is the livestock section, which is the real heart of the show. It is the largest collection of cattle seen together anywhere in southern England. It's one of the many reasons why it's so important to the farming community. The family lunch break is over, and time for the competition between the two friends to kick off again. Just a few last minutes for those all-important touch-ups.
It's like your foundation. You know, we're putting the foundation on the legs this time.
Trevor may have won the first competition, but Ben isn't beaten yet. He wants to make sure he has his best cows for the next round and asks Holly for advice.
What do you think this is pets?
Let's have a look. Yeah, definitely those two.
Because they're taking out two cows in this competition, Trevor's roping in his niece to help.
Maxine's the best handler here. She knows how to hold on to one if it goes a bit wild. She's stronger than me. She could pick me up in the air like that, so I gave her the one who's a bit tough.
Trevor's wife May and baby Hope are here to cheer them on. And the farmers are back in the ring. Whoever's cows are the most identical will win this one.
Me and Ben, we're basically focusing on each other in that class. With everybody else isn't there, to be honest with you.
Right, Ben?
This is one of the best lineups we've seen in a very long time.
There are a lot of buyers and dealers at the show today who are looking out for competition winners. Rosettes are invaluable to their businesses.
Showing's very important for the promotion of our cattle. Bringing them to the show is our shop window for all the other breeders to see the cows. And then winning makes it all the better for us.
But for Ben and Trevor, it's more personal than business.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've come into this pairs class. But when we're judging a pairs class, I like a pair to be a pair. And I'm going to go with this pair right here as my winning pair.
Trevor's done it again.
Super pair of cows, a real credit to the breeder.
That unbelievable feeling inside. The butterflies now have gone into something else. I think they've gone into like a swarm of bees and butterflies and everything. I just feel crazy inside.
Then we're going to go into this pair here, a super, super pair.
And Ben and Holly come in second place.
This is everyone. Well done.
Thank you.
He wants
the beer tokens.
I felt we had, I thought, a good pair, but they were second today. Felt a little bit hard done by. Just in my opinion.
Hey.
That's what we want to see. Red. Red is the best. Well, happy.
Trevor's cows, yeah, we don't judge faces, we judge the cows, and, you know, he's just been the guy that's got the right sort of cows today. But, yeah, very impressed with them.
Mate, I'm so happy. Doing all right.
Huh?
Really happy with that.
The day is beginning to come to an end, but the crowds are still flowing. In the cow tent, all thoughts are on the last competition. It's 2-0 to Trevor, but there's still everything to play for. Ben and Holly are double-checking everything.
Can you just check Norma?
Huh?
Hey, let Norma lay down. Do you want to just go and have a look at her?
Yeah.
I'll get your numbers.
Over at Trevor's stall, he has a few last-minute tricks up his sleeve.
Ollie's putting the baby oil on now. You're just rubbing it over the udder so it shines a little bit. And we always have one person to do that, because if you get baby oil on your hands, it's like a slippery fish, the halter is. You can't hold on to it. And it's the cow just runs away with you, and the halter goes over there, and you're like, bye-bye, cow, gone.
Andy. Meanwhile, for Ben and Holly, this is their last chance to get everything right. It could help Ben and Holly towards their dream of owning their own farm. And for Trevor, it could help him boost the size of his beloved herd. The judge lines them up for a final assessment. There's a lot riding on this. All Ben and Trevor can do is wait and hope. Won at last, with Trevor in second place.
It's good to have a bit of competition with Trevor again today, and just shows how close those two cows are, really.
Could have gone either way. It was like splitting hairs. He won that, so good on him. We've got to give him something, haven't we?
This prize has really given Ben and Holly a boost. It means that this young couple are on the road to success and a bright future in farming.
Yeah, I'm good. Being in the championship is really encouraging for the future to come back and try and do it again and do better.
It just means that we're doing things right when we're at home for the other 300 odd days.
Cast your eyes at the cattle that are coming through the gate now. We go to our dairy section and our supreme here is female.
Ben has awarded one last grand prize for breeding.
Cheers. Thanks so much.
All done for another year, and we've done all right, so happy days.
Slowly all the farmers make their way out. The day's been a triumph for everyone involved.
It's a drug and I'm addicted to it. It's great fun, and I've got friends all over the world from doing this job. Judging the shows is nice to meet people as well, and the respect that you get back from people is really, really good.
As the sight winds down, the families finally get a chance to reflect.
I think we've had a really good show this year. Good fun, good rivalry, and all worked out fair in the end, I guess.
We've had a good day, actually. We've had top-of-the-class wins, really, so really, really happy.
Brilliant. Absolutely over the moon at how we did today. The winning is really good promotion for our herd, and it's good building block for the future family, hopefully. It is a big family outing, really. It's a bit like a holiday. We don't get away from the farm much, so this is our fun break, really.
Yeah, that's true.
And the boys are already planning next year's showdown.
Next year, I think we get them lined up and see what happens then. You know,
That's it.
I've got a special. I've got another one in the jewel box at home, so I haven't taken it out yet.
Yeah, I got two I left this time that probably could have won today. But
really?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Across the country, thousands of farming families work tirelessly around the clock.
Stop arguing, girls! Give over!
But there's one day each year when they get to leave the daily routine behind.
Right, here we come, Dorset.
Fingers crossed.
There are nearly 10,000 dairy farms in the UK, home to almost 2 million cows. They supply us with millions of litres of milk every day, and are the backbone of British agriculture.
Come on.
Today we're meeting two families from Kent. Trevor Warren and Holly Bereen and Ben Dyer are getting ready to show their prize animals at this year's county show in Surrey. It's their chance to show their hard work to the world and to compete for top prizes.
Come on, girl.
On a farm just outside Dover in Kent, it's the start of a new day. It's 5 a.m. and Trevor and his son are already hard at work on the morning milking.
I love milk. I drink milk every day. I drink at least 3 pints, 4 pints a day. It gives me that, gives me a buzz when I drink it.
Well, I tell everybody, drink milk keeps you young.
For 42-year-old Trevor, dairy farming is a passion, handed down through generations.
My father's side were all herdsmen. My dad, he's milked cows. My granddad milked cows, and my great-granddad, he milked cows. It's a job, but it's also a hobby for me. The skill of getting high yields out of cows, that drives me. I mean, when the milk tanker comes and you get the milk ticket to see how much milk's in the tank, that gets me going big time, big time.
For Trevor, farming his 660 cows on his 800-acre farm is hard work with very long hours. He starts at 4 a.m. and he has a busy day full of milking and constantly tending to his herd. Luckily, he has a large family to help. His wife, May, is in charge of the calves.
When they see the bags, that means food time.
His eldest son, 22-year-old Sonny, works on the farm and manages his own herd of Jersey cows. While his other son, Ollie, works the tractor, helping with the harvest. Next comes 6-year-old daughter, Cleo, and 5-year-old son, Jude, and 4-year-old grandson, Tyler, who are all learning the ropes. Even new baby Hope is being started early.
Hope loves the cows. She loves coming out on the farm.
I'm passionate about encouraging youngsters into this industry.
Right, you're going to lead it?
There's a lot of youngsters who think it's just about work, 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 work. Well, it is hard work.
Hold this hand on.
But there's also a lot of passion, pride. My young son Jude, when he started to leave his calf, he was so proud of himself. You know, he wants to be like what I'm trying to do. That's why I do it. My daughter Cleo, she's like, Dad, I want to train my calf. But sometimes I have to calm her down, she's so keen.